How to add Google Analytics to Shopify. Hello there and welcome to another Wesley Walker video. I'm a data analytics manager and in this video I'm going to show you how you can add Google Analytics to your Shopify website. But before we begin, if any of you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe for more digital analytics, data analytics and e-commerce videos, and drop a like down below if you enjoyed this and hit that bell so you don't miss any of my future data, e-commerce or digital analytics videos. So what I have here is my Shopify store called Create, and what we're going to do is we're going to try and find out how you can add Google Analytics to this store. So at this moment in time, we actually have Google Analytics running on this website. I'm going to show you how you can add it to yours so you can understand how people are interacting with your website there and have better control of your analytics. And I can understand why people want to do this, because with Shopify's own analytics, your own sessions are counted in the hits. So if you read a website yourself, you're counted in your Shopify analytics. And if you have the basic Shopify plan, very, very basic information that you get out of it. So by being able to add Google Analytics yourself onto your own store, you have more freedom to play the data and customize it in ways that you want. And of course, you have the ability to create custom reports as well, which you can't do with the basic Shopify plan. It's also worth noting that there are multiple methods of adding Google Analytics to Shopify. There's the one method through Google Tag Manager. So you first install Google Tag Manager into your Shopify store through the theme, and then you'd install Google Analytics that way. Or you can use Shopify's own setup out-of-the-box solution for including Google Analytics onto the store. So we're going to do the out-of-box solution. And the reason being is that when you do the GTM setup, which I've done before on this specific Shopify site, and I've spoken to a few other people in the Shopify community, is that because in the feed you don't have access to editing the checkout Shopify file, you can't actually get GTM installed on it. So what that means is that if any customer goes onto your basket page and then goes into the checkout, you lose visibility of them, so you won't be able to track them in Google Analytics until they go to the confirmation page, which is obviously not ideal for analytics, because you want to be able to analyze each step of the checkout process. But if you try to track GA via GTM, you're not going to be able to do that. The only way that you can do that, I believe, is by upgrading your plan on Shopify to like the premium plan, and then you have access to the checkout file. But of course, that solution is not going to be available to everyone. So we'll go through the standard way to do it, which is the way that allows you to capture every single interaction. So when you first open up your Shopify portal, you'll see your homepage, and from here you need to go onto your online store, and then click on preferences. And if you scroll down, you'll see a Google Analytics account. So I have something included right now, but I'll just change that. So let's just remove this for a few seconds. So you'll see that you don't have anything. So Shopify is asking you for your Google Analytics code, and all you need is the profile ID, essentially. So when you go into GA, and this is assuming you've already created your Google Analytics account, which is very, very straightforward to do. But if any of you need a walkthrough on how to do that, let me know and I'll create a video for that as well. So you go into your GA. So once you've set it up, you go into your admin, which is set in the bottom left here, and then you click on property settings. And then all you need to copy here is your tracking ID. So now we go back into Shopify, paste your tracking ID, make sure there are no spaces, click save, and then you click enable used enhanced e-commerce. So this will do it by default, but you want to make sure that's enabled, because the enhanced e-commerce version gives you like product information, product data, and just gives you more actionable insights. You don't want to use just the standard version. You definitely want to enable enhanced e-commerce. So once you've done that, if your website starts getting some sessions, you should see information like this when you go into your GA, which populates it. So this isn't my own data, this is the sample data. But you should begin to see the usage. So you'll see the users come to your website, the conversion rate, sessions, revenue if any batches have been captured, once you've added on the Google Analytics tagging. And then you'll also be able to do much more significant measurements. So you'll be able to see the traffic the traffic information. You'll be able to look at your marketing acquisition rates, get a better understanding of the behaviors of your customers, the people who visit your website. Audience overviews, you just get much more granular information that you'll be able to be in control of, which of course is much more useful. So this is pretty much it. This is the video on how to add Google Analytics onto your Shopify account. So let me know if you found this video helpful and insightful, And if there are any questions that you have on your Shopify journey or your Google Analytics journey or the two of them, be sure to let me know in the comment section below, and I'll see you on my next video.